Justin, can you hear us okay?
Yep.
All right, we'll get started. We'll start first with Pete Sweeney. Go ahead, Pete.
Hey, Justin, it seems like you personally and really the defense as a whole is settling in here. Not that you weren't playing good at the, you know, different parts of the season, but really in this last game. Any rhyme or reason to why it feels like you're entering the playoffs and stretch a strong note?
Yeah, I mean, this is the time of year that you want to get hot. I mean, there's a lot of new faces coming into this defensive system. Like I said at the beginning of the year, that the playbook was deep, and, you know, really the best way to get experience is just through reps. So our young guys have been getting a lot of reps under their belts. Like I said earlier, they're no longer rookies or first-year players. Me, myself, got a lot of reps under the belt now and started settling into the system and really know what the coaches are driving for and what they want us, the defense, to look like. So it's coming together at a good time. We were able to finish the regular season on a high note, and we're going to have to take that momentum with us whenever we start approaching this first game of the playoffs.
Let's go next to Aaron Ladd. Go ahead, Aaron.
Hey, appreciate the time here. Pat just kind of told us that, you know, you all were ready to play wherever as far as the scenarios were concerned and what the league decided on doing with the AFC title game and the no contest. Can you kind of walk me through what your mindset was as this whole thing was kind of shaking out, and then kind of how you see it with y'all being the one seed going forward?
Yeah, actually, you know, for a player, it's, you know, for me, it's pretty simple. You know, we can't control any of those extenuating circumstances. We can't control where we play, when we play. The only thing we control is how we play and to be ready for that moment whenever that happens. So however the cards were folded on the table, we're going to be prepared for it. It was fortunate for us that we were able to get the number one seed. That's something that we aimed for at the beginning of the season. So congratulations to our team on being able to do that. And, you know, wherever we end up playing next, however these scenarios play out, wherever that location and time is, we're going to get ready to play and we're going to play.
Let's go next to Herbie Teope. Go ahead, Herbie.
Justin, as a quick follow-up to Pete's question, and you mentioned all the moving pieces back there on the defense, especially on defensive back group. What point of the season do you think the light bulb came on and you were able to take some of the stuff that happened early in the season to get you to where you are now?
Yeah, you know, throughout the year, I felt like we were always very close. It just ends up being like a play here, a play there, a couple inches away each time. Say around the start of December, the confidence level in the room really started to take off. And, you know, guys were really confident in not only their own play and their teammates' play, trusting each other that we're going to take care of our responsibilities and being able to play off each other. And you see that, especially in this last game right here, all three phases, offense, defense, special teams, were able to end on a high note. So that's big for us momentum-wise. We're going to have to continue to build on that. And we know that the road is only going to get tougher from here, so we're going to have to bring our best football going into when we play these playoff games.
Let's go next to Seren Petro. Go ahead, Seren.
Justin, I think the first 12 games, you guys had 12 takeaways. You bumped that up to 8 over the last 5 games. And I know that was something that Steve Spagnuolo talked about, was maybe the next evolution. He pointed out some of your young DBs, not just being in position, but being in position, get your head around, be in position to make a play. You know, do you think you were maybe a little snake bitten at getting some of the takeaways? Maybe you guys were due. Or do you think this is more than just a trend and more than just based upon maybe the level of opponent you've had that you guys can consistently take it away?
Yeah, well, you know, throughout this league, it's a funny scenario, man. Like, when they tend to come in bunches. So if I had to choose any time for year for them to really start getting hot, of course, we want to choose right now for the turnover, that turnover machine to start kicking into action. So really been ball savvy. Coach Spagnuolo and all the defensive skill coaches are really focused and harped on getting the ball out each year. But as the level of the defense and confidence of the defense has risen, we're able to make a couple more of those plays and have the ball swing our way.
Let's go next to Nate Taylor. Go ahead, Nate.
Hey, Justin, thanks for doing this. My question is about you, Juan, and Brian. There was so much talk when the season began about how you guys were going to be interchangeable. How much do you think you guys have obviously gelled as a core together and what you guys might present in the postseason through playing experience?
Yeah, complete confidence in each other. Three-headed snake, all very smart players, understand route concepts, understand defense. Juan has been here going into his fourth year, but Brian Cook and myself can all play both roles. You know, Brian come in and sometimes being Ron's role, sometimes being my role throughout training camp, even took some dime reps too. So we're confident in him being wherever he needs to be. And like I said, as the experience and the reps under the belt have started to accumulate, you're starting to see that value start to turn out on the football field. And it's a good time for it to happen.
And we'll go last to Herbie. Go ahead, Herbie.
Hey, Justin, another quick follow-up to the earlier question. You mentioned the start of December is when it started to come together. So safe to say after the Bengals game is when y'all had like little mini discussion and said, this is what we need to do going forward.
Yeah, I mean, that's the game we wanted to win. Very competitive team, talented roster they have over there. And that was also a moment for ourselves that we wanted to take it. And we didn't want to have another loss after that. So we're able to keep that going. Obviously, these next three games, we want to focus on the first game first. But it's a new season at this point. We have to go 1-0 each week. And we got to bring that same attitude mentality since that week with us the rest of the year.
Justin, we appreciate the time. Thanks for joining us.
Yes, sir.
All right, guys, that is it for today. Give me 1 second here. I'll jump back on and answer any questions for you.